don't even have this religious authority. In our religion, an imam can stand before people like you today and should believe in his heart that many of you are ahead of me. In our religion, we don't have this religious authority, while we need someone to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In terms of without him or her, we will not be able to be close. Our religion, it's actually a direct communication between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Something I remember saying to a pastor, and I said to him, this is why I am really proud of Islam as a religion. Often we assume that, do you know what, we are Muslims, like you or me or anyone, buying a special gift to your kid or one of the children, and you intend to say to him, this is a special gift. I want you to be careful with it. This is value, is this and that. I feel like we have to recognize Islam as a special gift, and we should revisit our approach toward Islam. Secondly, I watch closely as well the Senate, the people within the House trying to pass this stimulus package to help people. It is obvious, and everyone can agree with me about this, that politics become really big part of it. And it's a tactic while everyone trying to score a point here or there. I said to myself, watching one of those news show, I said Islam is so powerful. Islam recognizes helping people as an act of worship. And recognizing this to be an essential part of Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught the Rasul to say to us, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ. Raising the morality of the individual as well as the society is one of the Islamic achievements, and actually one of the core value of Islam as a religion. Even when disliking people, liking or disliking has a relationship with everyone's right being met and everyone's being taken care of. I remember that Sayyidina Umar, when he spoke to the man killed Hamza ibn Abd al-Muttalib, and he said, I don't want to see you, be away from him. The man, the one of the Islamic figure, and become Muslim. And he said to him, هل يمنعك هل يمنعني حبك أو بغضك لي حقا هو لي. Will your feeling being positive or negative about me affect my rights? Sayyidina Umar said to him, no. قال لا. The man was a Bedouin. He looked to him back and he said, إنما يبكي على الحب النساء. I don't really care. The only one who is worried about feelings is women. Are women, and I am not. Here is the point. Even if we liking or disliking someone, everyone's right has to be taken care of. This is an Islamic position we should be proud of. Someone said to me one time in a church, and he said, In Christianity is very special. I said, I'm glad. And he said, because in Christianity, we taught our kids to love their neighbor as their, love your neighbor as yourself. I see that beautiful teaching. But in Islam, went ahead of you guys, because you recognize neighbor to be someone living next to you. But in our religion, in Islam, elevate the concept of neighborhood. والجاري ذي القربة والجاري الجنوبي والصاحب بالجنب وابن السبيل. Literally, anyone you are in any we come in interaction with is your neighbor. When I flew to Corbus, the one was sitting next to me, Islamically speaking, is my neighbor, and he has a right. Someone and I speak with, someone passing by the city, Islam recognizes anyone in any interaction with you as your neighbor. A concept I assume, at least I don't know, that any religion really recognize the entire human family to be your neighbor, an Islamic teaching. This is why I said I am really proud of Islam. I watched the debate just last night, and everyone is trying to say something, and I came to remember that in our religion, leadership is a responsibility. People, Islamically speaking, shouldn't be eager to hold the position. If they are qualified, they try their very best, and if they do well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward them. Al-Hakim al-Adil, salatuhu sab'una alfa salah, wa du'a'uhu mustajabun idha da'a. A righteous ruler, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah will multiply the reward of his or her salah up to 70,000. And anytime he will make dua, Allah will accept from him. This is the beauty of Islam as a religion. For a while, the Muslim community, especially in the West, we've been put in the corner while we have to speak about terrorist activity or radicalism, and we have to condemn all of the time. And I feel strongly that we have to get out of this corner to recognize that the Muslims are really a key part of the solution. When someone was asking me about voting, why and should we vote or not, and he assumed that is an issue of al-wala and al-bara, and I said, ya akhi, al-wala and al-bara got nothing to do with voting at all. Al-wala and al-bara is an issue related to the faith. Otherwise, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam moved to the city of al-Madinah and recognized the citizenship to be an umbrella everyone enjoy. Al-Rasul went as far as saying, when he made this deal with the Jewish community in al-Madinah, Banu Qurayza, Banu Qaynuqa, and Banu Nadir, he said, we will die protecting them, and they will die protecting us. Al-Rasul said, and they call ummatun wahida, we are one nation. Al-Rasul identified and recognized the concept of citizenship to be an umbrella within the Islamic teaching, while people can have agreement or disagreement. This is why I see us voting not only something the country expected from us, but I see it as a way of us sharing with the people around us our value. We are part of the solution. We are part of the solution. When I watch, I read the day before yesterday that the Pope start to be little easy little bit recognizing the right or of the homosexual to have a union. I said it seems like Islam now is standing alone to protect the human family from a disease might destroy the entire family. This is why I feel like we have to get out of the corner. We have to start seeing ourselves as a special part of the society. We have a very unique and special gift, a gift we should share with everyone. When speaking about it, da'wah and inviting people to Islam, our main desire is really to protect their dignity, a good way of life. If they become Muslim, they are our brothers. If they will not become Muslim, we respect them and we can see them as our brothers and sisters without any doubt. But I feel like we should be proud of our religion. I see Corona and the COVID-19 to be a special gift. Why? It's a challenge. But it helps us to recognize what we have. How many among us recognize traveling comfortably in an airplane as ni'mah? Furthermore, how many among us recognize having a nice chat with a friend or giving someone a hug or shake hand as a ni'mah? How many of us recognize this? We suddenly now, we start to realize that we have many ni'mah. I was reading back Ibn Atai when he mentioned that being able to recognize the ni'am of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a ni'mah by itself. Very powerful, really, because sometimes unconsciously we take things for granted. I thought I will share those points with you today, that we should not only be happy that we are Muslim, but we should be proud. We participate actively in politics because we are part of the solution. We care about our neighbors. We care about everyone. We see Islam as a very advanced and a very unique way of life. And in my opinion, if people want to enjoy life, they should really practice the Islamic way of life. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ومولانا رسول الله. ثم أما بعد, being in interaction with many community like many of you, I feel the need of each one of us sharing with the people around him or her a good story that some brother did this and the brother did that. I start to be concerned each time we speak about religion, we bring to everyone attention what Abu Bakr did and what Sayyidina Umar did. What Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Umar did is wonderful, but I think we have to start being optimistic about what we have. The Muslim community, young and old, male and female, are doing really wonderful work in America. And unfortunately, often we raise the challenge. Many Muslims now running for office. We have the young Muslims doing really good in the higher education in America. And I was pleased to hear an anchor saying, if you want to be safe, live next to a Muslim, because they will not party at night. There's no drinking. They care about education. They care about morality. They are good people. It was not Muslim, but I thought it's something we should all recognize. We should all recognize. When we sit together, if your son or daughter today is 30 years old, share with the brothers in the community what you did with him or with her if she is a daughter. Let us learn from each other. The idea of being worried about sharing something good about your son or daughter is a crazy idea to start with. We learn from each other. The Muslim community in America, we have no choice but to see each other as a member of the same family. If you disagree with me from a religious perspective, politically, we have to be one team. Otherwise, we will not go anywhere. We will continue to struggle. The solution is to eliminate this issue of Far East and the Middle East and the American border, to see each other as one family. Salman minna ahl al-bayt. The Rasul said, Salman is a member of my family. It's a disease existing within some community, but fortunately, within the West in particular, you can see so much progress in this area, especially with the second and the third generation. They love each other and they see each other really as a member of the same family. We assume that the first generation is the one protecting Islam, but I want to let you know that some of the second and the third generation doing a wonderful work because they are Muslim because of Islam, not because they were born in Egypt and it happened that the parents were Muslim, something we should all appreciate and we should all really recognize. What should you do? I think each one of us must, including me, identify an area of talent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you a special gift. You have to find this gift. And you have to say, no, I'm really good in this. And share with people and use this talent to improve the entire community, not only the Muslim community, but the community in Corpus Christi, if we are speaking about Corpus Christi. If each one of us choose to share the gift he or she has with the people around us, I think we'll move more effectively. Let us speak about Islam with everyone, not really about Osama bin Laden and Al-Qaeda and the September the 11th. Let us speak about the Islamic morality and the Islamic way of life. Let us recognize Islam really to be a special gift. We will not be able to share this with others unless we are convinced that Islam is a special gift. I really believe that Islam is the most special gift that we have. Fascinating religion. When studying sometime Usul al-Fiqh, I become fascinated by the beautiful intellectual approach toward everything in life. This is in Islam. Shira'at Allah. No one is better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to teaching and informing people with the proper way, with the proper way of life. I see in a challenge, you can shift in a challenge to become a gift, including this virus. And through this virus, we learn what we have and we learn the dynamic and the realistic approach of our religion. Through this election season, we recognize the power of Islam and we see the need of a Muslim community acting as an American Muslim, as part of this society, having the need to vote and to participate, not only because we want someone to win, but because we want to improve the status of the country. We live in America and we care deeply about this country. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us this. The idea that I am an Egyptian all of the time and living in America my entire life is crazy to start with. How can you live the entire life in a country? I am not saying you must dismiss the country we came from, but I am saying we have to care about this country as well. This is what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. After Fath Mecca, when the Sahaba raised the concern, Al-Ansar, are you going to go back to Mecca? قال المدينة فيها أحيا وفيها أموت لو سلك الناس شعبا وسلك الأنصار شعبا لسلكت شعب الأنصار. After Fath Mecca and after the conquest of Mecca and the Ansar, the people of Medina start to be worried. Are you going back to your town? And Rasul said, no. If the people are to go one way and the people of Ansar were to go another, I will go with the people of Ansar. I will live here and I will die here. And the Rasul taught us through this example that we should care about the country we live in. I learned through the last few months the power of the Muslim community, the power of Islam, the power and the beauty of the very many good activities I think we should all share. I think we have to get out of the corner and recognize that we have challenges and we have sometimes disagreement. And having disagreement should be exist in any community, but we disagree heavily while loving and caring about each other. I remember Justice Scalia, a conservative judge passed away. He used to say, attacking ideas, not an individual. This is what the Rasul, the Quran al-Karim actually said, وَأَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. When you meet Allah, you have this clearness in your heart all of the time. I hope this can serve as a reminder for me and for my dear brothers and sisters in here in this community. Very special and the kind community. If you travel a lot, you will come to know that Corpus Christi might be a small Muslim community, but the good, very educated community. And the most of I know about this community is really good. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless everyone in this beautiful community. And may Allah make it easy for all of us to enjoy the new masjid. And may Allah make it easy for us to be a model for everyone. And may Allah make it easy for us to raise our voice, to be proud of our affiliation with Islam. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى لي ولكم ذلك. أسأل الله أن يحفظنا وأن يحفظ أبنائنا وأن يحفظ بناتنا. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن ييسر علينا الإسلام. May Allah make it easy for us to be Muslim and to be proud of this religion. اللهم إنك أقرأتنا القرآن فارزقنا اللهم فهم مرادك. يا رب, you made it easy for us to recite the Quran. Make it easy for us to understand your message. May Allah make it easy for each one of us to understand his message, to move from practicing Islam to become in love with this religion. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for each one of us to move from performing the movement of Salah to make it easy for us, for our heart to be in it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the most special honor of being with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us the greatest honor of all, which is being able to see the Almighty Jalla Jalaluhu in Jannah. أسأل الله أن يغفر لآبائنا ولأمهاتنا وأن يبارك في ذرياتنا وأن يرزقنا جميعا حسن الخاتمة. عباد الله, اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم وسلوه يعطيكم وأقم الصلاة. الأخ ألمجير, he mentioned that الأخ أمان الله in the hospital today. He's been admitted to the hospital. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for him and they grant him a speedy recovery. Also brother Umar, his sister passed away. May Allah, brother Umar from Lebanon, his sister passed away. May Allah watch over her. And inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her Jannat al-Firdaus. Brother Shihab, mother-in-law, passed away as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her Jannat al-Firdaus. Allahumma, Allahumma ameen. Jazakum Allahu khayran. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la